Hello, this is Dr. Ayub. Today I'm going to teach you the upper extremity venous return. Okay, upper extremity venous return. Upper extremity venous returns. So, upper extremity means our two upper extremities that starts from the, finally it ends with the brachiocephalic vein, and the two brachiocephalic vein joins together to form the superior vena cava. And when we understand the brachiocephalic vein or innominate vein, then we have to understand that upper extremity blood is also merging with the venous return from the external and internal jugular vein from each side. And those are the blood that comes from the superficial tissues of the head, neck, face, and also the deeper blood that is from the brain, meninges. All those blood are venous blood returning and joining with the subclavian vein. Okay, and finally it forms the brachiocephalic vein, and the two brachiocephalic vein joins together forms the superior vena cava. Okay, so now upper extremity venous return, as usual with the lower extremity venous return, it is conducted by superficial venous system, then communicating or perforating venous system, and number three is a deep venous system. Okay, so these three contribution perform the upper extremity venous return. Okay, the superficial venous system I will discuss, then I will discuss the deep venous system, and then I will show at the same time that how the superficial vein and the deep vein are communicating each other. Those are the communicating vein or perforating veins. Okay, let's talk about the superficial venous system. Superficial venous system, it has a dorsal venous arch. Dorsal venous arch, which is formed by the superficial veins returning blood from the skin level of the dorsal or back of the digits. Okay, so that dorsal venous arch is formed around here. And this venous arch, if I draw it for you, Okay, so this is dorsum. Okay, so the venous arch, I'm just showing you the veins. Okay, and they join and they form an arch. Okay, so these are the dorsal digital vein, and this is the dorsal venous arch. And from the dorsal venous arch, the other veins' blood, the joins together. Okay, the two major veins, okay, let me show you here. Major dorsal superficial vein system from the upper extremity developed. You have to understand the how did it develop. This is the radial side. So this is beginning of the cephalic vein. And this is beginning of the basilic vein. Okay, so now this cephalic vein is on the lateral side and it collects blood mainly from the superficial veins, superficial blood from both sides, dorsal and the ventral side, or along the radial side, that is cephalic, and basilic, ventral and dorsal along the medial surface of the forearm. So cephalic collects blood from the back and front superficial venous blood along the radial side, that is lateral, and this is on the ulnar side, that is medial of the forearm. Okay, so now I'm just showing you the two blood venous system they develop. Okay, and make sure that during their this type of course they are also communicating each other, they are also communicated each other in this way. Okay, so we understood the two important vein, that is cephalic and basilic. Okay, keep that in mind. Now I will draw the deep venous system, then I will show you the communicating system, because the superficial vein, they return their blood through the deep vein, through the deep vein. Okay, that's why This vein, ultimately, the cephalic vein, it joins into the axillary vein, and the basilic vein, they join into the brachial vein. So axillary vein and the brachial vein, these are deep system vein. Okay, so now superficial begins from the dorsal venous arch, and the dorsal venous arch forms the cephalic vein and basilic vein. Okay, leave it like that. Now, communicating vein is communicated, is communicating the superficial and the deep vein. So now let's talk about the deep venous system. Deep venous system, they form the from the ventral or palmar surface. Okay, so first of all, digital veins. And these digital veins are superficial and deeper. Okay? Digital veins, superficial and deeper. And this digital vein forms the metacarpal veins. Metacarpal veins. Okay, two sets of metacarpal veins. Metacarpal veins are also superficial and the deeper. Okay, now superficial metacarpal veins form the ulnar vein. Okay, ulnar vein along the medial side of the forearm, and deeper metacarpal veins form the radial vein. Okay? And this ulnar vein and radial veins are paired vein. Paired. And they are known as vena comitantis of the ulnar artery and vena comitantis of the radial artery. Okay? So, so far we understood the deep venous system that begins at the deeper surface of the palm, okay, and there are superficial digital vein and deeper digital vein, and both the digital veins forms the two arch, okay, superficial venous arch and the deeper venous arch. Okay, and this arch is formed by the superficial metacarpal vein and the deeper metacarpal veins. Okay, so if I arch that vein, then I can show you here, say Okay, so this is this Palmer surface. So now the digital veins okay, two sets of digital vein. One is deeper, another is superficial, and the deeper and superficial if I show it here, okay, I'm just showing it here with the multiple branches. One is going this, another is going this. Just to show you that two sets of metacarpal, one is superficial, okay, one is superficial metacarpal, another is deeper metacarpal. Okay, now I will show you the deeper metacarpal forms the arch, okay, this is superficial, is very interesting that the one radial vein is now splitting into two. Okay, the same way, let me draw the hand. Okay, now I'm going to show you the another arch. Okay, let me show it here, the superficial in this part, so that you can recognize Okay. Very interesting. Look at here. This is digital vein that is superficial and the deeper. And these are the metacarpal veins. This is superficial metacarpal vein, and this is deeper metacarpal vein. Okay, so this metacarpal veins, they form the arch. One is deeper venous arch. Let me show you. So this is deeper venous arch, and deeper venous arch forms the radial vein. And these are known as veni comitantes of radial artery. Same thing, the superficial venous arch forms the superficial is this they form the ulnar vein, and that ulnar vein again is split into a pair known as same as veni comitantes of ulnar artery. Okay, so now we get the superficial, then we get the deeper. Now look at here, this two vein, radial vein and ulnar vein, they join together. And forms the brachial vein. Brachial vein. Okay, so now this brachial vein is the vein for the arm. Okay, vein for the arm. That's why its name is brachial. Okay, and let me draw the okay, brachial. And now look at here, this brachial vein receive the basilic vein. Okay, this brachial vein receive the basilar vein. This basilar vein is the superficial vein. Okay, so now this is still the brachial vein. Brachial vein. And at one point, and that point is the outer border of the teres major muscle, this brachial vein's name is axillary vein. Okay, from this point it goes Its name is axillary vein. This is axillary vein. And this axillary vein receives blood from the cephalic vein. Okay, so this is cephalic vein. Try to understand this. Cephalic vein and basilic vein or basilar vein, they are the superficial vein, and they need to drain into the heart. How? The basilic vein drains blood into the brachial vein. Basilic. And the cephalic vein drains into the axillary vein. Okay? And this axillary vein will run and at the outer border of the first rib, is name changed. Its name is subclavian vein. So this is outer border of the first rib. So subclavian vein, its name is subclavian vein. This would be here. The subclavian vein